But I think the main question here is like, what do I, like, should I feel guilty about not working on my commute? And let me put it this way. I mean, obviously you want to, if you have a goal, you need to use your time as effectively as possible to achieve that goal. But your attention and your energy are more important than your time. And if you are constantly stressing yourself out by thinking you need to wring productivity out of every single moment, then that attention and that energy are going to wane. And yeah. Your time is going to be used less effectively across the board. Moreover, if this helps you at all, ask yourself, what would I do if I had to commute in a different way? Because the only way that I can think of where commuting can be used for productivity, like work time, is whether you're on a train or a plane. If you're driving, I guess if you're like riding a bus, I guess that would work too.
Oh, but yeah,
if you're driving, you can listen to podcasts. You can, I guess you could like be a business guy on a Bluetooth headset and be like making deals while driving, which is probably not a good idea because even talking distracts you from driving. You could listen to maybe a language learning podcast or an audiobook. That's about it. You can't be managing your calendar while driving. I bike to work. I can't manage my calendar while biking to work. All I can do is listen to an audiobook or a podcast, and then I can consider my biking productive because it's making me healthier. Not only is it making me a better athlete, but it's also, as we talk about a zillion times, and as John Rady's book Spark talks about, it is making me a better brain worker when I get to work because aerobic exercise actually boosts cognitive performance.
Yeah.
But I'm not managing my to-do list and I'm not organizing my notes on the bike. So maybe this will help you. Like, okay, I'm going to pretend that my commute method is biking or driving, even though I'm on a train. Just be like, all right, that time is blocked out. All I can do is listen to something or stare at the trees and meditate and, you know, just be in the present.
Yeah, and if you're building up that energy to use later, then that still is productive. Being meditative or in the moment is very productive if you're using it to restore your mental reserves.
Yeah.
And also, this kind of goes back to what I said in the last episode about being motivated by negative motivators as opposed to positive ones.
Mm-hmm.
If I guilt myself into wringing every single possible work second out of my day, I'm just going to be stressed all the time. I'm not going to be happy, and I'm going to be giving worse work.
Yeah.
It's not going to be as good as if I took the commute, if I took the extra 5 minutes waiting in line to just kind of look at how the sun hits the trees and enjoy existing for a second.
Mm-hmm.
Then I'll be happy and excited to go to work, not melting down because I never give myself a chance to be a person.
Mm-hmm.